So I'm back out on site doing EICRs with Marcus, and this is one of those things where you take a deep breath because we're in an extended shower area for a sports team and there is a light fitting in with us. So what's the thinking here then?
Yeah, so immediately you come into somewhere like this and you walk into a shower and you see a light there and you panic and you're like, oh my God, the zones and everything else that comes into mind straight away. And like you said, you probably overthink it and think, well, that's definitely going to have a code. It's definitely going to be a C2. But when you actually break it down, it's where the inspection is rather important. When we actually look at the manufacturer's ratings and their values on the inside of this light fitting, it states it's IP65. And when we look in the on-site guide, we look at the zone we're in. So we've measured from floor to ceiling. We're actually within zone one. So this is not outside of the zones. So we're in zone one here. So we have a look at what we're allowed in this zone and what the necessary IP ratings have to be. So in zone one, it talks about IPX4 as a minimum. We have IP65. So we've superseded the IPX4 anyway with this IP65 fitting here. And then it also talks about different voltages. But there's the small section at the bottom of the paragraph where it talains about the equipment allowed, and it says a mains voltage, let's say 230 volts single phase, can be a variety of things, and luminaires is included within that sentence. Actually, where we first come in and we maybe overthink it, we're going to give this no code at all because the fitting itself is suitable, but the inspection is important. We have to make sure it hasn't been damaged in any way because we are for a sports team, you know, things get silly in the shower maybe when you're a bit younger. Make sure there's, you know, the seal's intact, there's no signs of moisture gotten inside of the fitting. We also have RCD protection at 30 milliamps for additional protection, so we're going to actually go with no code for this one.
Absolutely, and if there's anyone got any comments, leave them below. If this is something you would have panicked about and thought it wasn't allowed and you've just gone through the on-site guide and checked, please leave those comments below and check out the video on screen now where we do some more EICR coding.